Hey guys, welcome to Exercise Journey Day 11. I wanted to start off by showing my overall activity for the day and kind of just walking through how the day went. I would say it was a pretty good day today overall, both from an activity perspective and from an eating perspective. Not gonna say it was the best from an eating perspective just because I had pizza again for lunch, but I really enjoyed the workout that I did today and just how the day went overall and where I kind of increased what I've been talking about in my first couple videos, increased my NEAT, which is non-exercise activity thermogenesis. I think I did a good amount of that today, and I'm just going to walk through kind of how I did it. So as you guys can see here, I had burned 750 of 740 active calories today, which is pretty good. Obviously, the majority of it came from the workout that I did today, which was actually I participated in my coworker April's yoga class for the first time today at 6:30 in the afternoon, which was awesome. I loved getting to participate in that and just try a different type of exercise. And then as you can see at 12 noon, as well as after the workout, I got a little bit of NEAT going just with the 12 noon was actually walking my dogs. And then the after the workout was just me doing some jumping jacks randomly, honestly, before I got in the shower. So it's just figuring out little ways to kind of make it fun. Like I was doing jumping jacks as I was checking lights to get ready for bed and checking the alarm, all of that stuff, just kind of being silly with it. As you can see, there is a little bit of a increase in calorie burns before my workout too, because I actually took my dogs on a long walk around the nature path, I guess you can call it, in our community. And I got a video of that, or a few videos of that actually. So I'll go into that walk with my dogs, and then I'll go into the exercise videos that I captured. It's just really a representation of the different yoga poses and stuff that we did. But before we get into that, wanted to go through the specific exercise minutes. So I got 57 minutes of exercise, and as you can see, the workout was the longest amount since it was about a 50 minute workout for when I jumped in to when we were done with the workout. And then I got 13 standing hours of 12 today, and I got only 6,000 steps. I'm still trying to figure out how to increase my steps throughout the day. It's just hard, you know, being someone who sits down and inside for work all day. But before we get into the videos of the walk and the workout, just going through the workout specifically, I had an average heart rate of 94 beats per minute, but I burned 235 calories, which was really good. It was a pretty intense yoga session, and I love getting to participate in it. So now I'll walk you through the walk with my dogs. I'll show you the walk with my dogs. I'll show you a few of the yoga poses we did. It's a very small portion of the entire routine, but I just wanted to give you an example of what it looked like. And then I'll go into my calories today to finish it off. So hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah.
Hey guys, so I just wanted to finish off the video by showing you what my calorie intake for the day was. So today, I didn't eat a lot of calories. Obviously, I only had 1,259, which is 300 under my goal of 1,500 daily calories. But the thing of it is I had pizza for lunch again, and that was the majority of my calories for the day. So not the healthiest choice, and I'm gonna be a little relieved when that pizza gets finished. I just hate wasting food and love the taste of pizza. So great excuse to continue eating it. But the thing that I loved that I got to eat today was honestly my wife, Elena, bless her heart again, made us a very, very healthy breakfast for dinner today. So she did egg whites for me with turkey bacon, sugar-free syrup, and one small Belgian waffle. And it all came out to only 370 calories. I honestly wish I had known it was only 370 calories when I ate it, because I probably would have had a lot more of it. It was delicious. And we're definitely going to make that part of our weekly dinner schedule. But it was an awesome dinner, a lot lower in calories than I thought, and really high in protein, as you can imagine. So shout out again to Lena for just making it to where eating healthy for dinner is always easy. And then for a couple snacks today, I had a lemon bar and some Jack Link's. I think they were like beef steaks or tender bites, whatever they were, that were 70 calories. I also had a Bang, which is like a high caffeine but zero calorie energy drink that's like natural. I love those for when I'm feeling like I need to pick me up and don't feel like having coffee or just out real quick. So that was a enjoyable part of my day, but I'm not really seeing a lot of progress in my physique overall. And I think that might be because the amount of carbs I'm eating with the pizza and the amount of sugar I'm taking in with the Bangs and with the snacking that I'm doing. So I think I'm gonna need to address that moving forward, but I've also only been doing this for 11 days. So it's like, you gotta give yourself a little bit of grace with this stuff and give yourself enough time to truly analyze where you were previously and where you are now, and kind of give yourself an honest look. Not so much just saying, hey, I don't have a six pack after 11 days, I gotta change something, you know? So I'm aware of that, but it is tempting to try to go to the extreme-ish dieting that I was doing previously so I can start to feel like I'm seeing results again. So just giving you a little idea of where my head's at. If you guys have any tips or thoughts on how to kind of mitigate that mindset, or just, you know, kind of stick to the plan, let me know. I'd love to hear it. Thank you.